How's it going?
As today is Thursday, don't worry, I will be talking about the news. First off, though, I would just like to point out the awesomeness of this hat. Because one of my loyal fans, Miss M, made it for me. It says Keps right here. I don't know if you can tell because the lighting's not very good in here, but it says Keps in purple writing, and it makes, well, stitching, and it makes me very happy. So, today I was looking through some articles, and I didn't quite know what to talk about. And I'm looking around. At first I thought maybe I would talk about E3, I think it's at E3, where the gaming companies are all introducing their new systems, you know, Sony and Microsoft and Nintendo. But, you know, it just didn't really catch my eye. I don't know, all these like 3D graphics and full body suits and the motion sensitive controllers, it didn't really catch my fancy, and it would have been a very long episode. So I decided I was going to talk about jaguars. No, not the car. I'm talking about the animal, the jungle cat. Yes, I know that this sounds very random. My reasoning is because as I was looking through all these articles, I found two completely separate ones that were both about jaguars. And so I thought, you know, I would try to connect them, see what they were about. And since I went ahead and read them and thought in my head about how to connect them, I decided that's what I will talk about. Mind you, these were both from Yahoo News, just so I'm citing my sources. But the first one was all about how researchers are using Calvin Klein cologne's obsession for men to attract jaguars. They did some tests with various scents, and I guess that one held their attention the longest, and so they kept coming back and smelling it. So they're using it to kind of lure jaguars in and keep them in certain areas, and they can use it so they can, like, observe mating behavior and track them and, you know, all of that jazz. A word to the wise. Men, if you're out in the jungle, lay off on the cologne. And all this research is happening down in Guatemala, where they're trying to help, you know, conserve the jaguars because, you know, deforestation is happening and that's ruining habitats and killing all the animals, and it's really sad, so they're trying to work on keeping them wild and free and alive and all that jazz. The second article moves about 3,000 miles south down from Guatemala to Brazil, and instead of talking about conservation, it's talking about jaguar hunting habits, and how it affects the cattle of ranchers in the area. Now, I think that these two article writers, or the scientists from each article, need to work together, because in the second article, they're talking about how it's very difficult for them to track jaguar movements. They end up putting collars on them that send out a signal every 2 hours so they can track their movements and find their kills and hunting and check out so they can know their hunting patterns. And they did this, they found out that the jaguars killed about a third cattle and then two-thirds native species, depending on the rainfall in the area. But they were having difficulty, you know, working with the locals, who obviously are not okay with the wildcats killing their livestock. Anyway, though, the two people in these two studies obviously need to work together, because if the scientists in Brazil are having so much trouble tracking their jaguars, why not try some Calvin Klein cologne obsession for men on them? Then again, I guess I don't know. Maybe Brazilian jaguars prefer another brand to Calvin Klein. I don't actually know many cologne brands, but I'm sure there are many of them out there. But yeah, in the second article, they said that they found that the jaguars tended to group together, not like a pride, but as like groups of males who would hunt together and all that jazz, and that there's a lot more than they anticipated, and that they kill a lot more cattle than ranchers estimated every year. So that's a big problem in Brazil, and, you know, it's understandable that they want to work out a compromise, because you don't want them to just go out and kill all the jaguars, because that's the problem that is being faced in Guatemala, is that there aren't many left. So I think that they should, I don't really know, but they should probably try to work out a compromise. I'm not sure what, but hopefully they'll think of something. So yeah, kind of a slow news week, I guess. I didn't find anything that caught my eye. A lot of it was the war, and there were a couple still on the oil spill. And, you know, like I said, some things on gaming and all that, but maybe I'll try a little harder next week. I'm not feeling it today. I'm very tired and all that jazz. I should stop making excuses, though. I'm sorry. I will try harder next time. I hope that you enjoyed this episode. My name is Keps, and I approve this message.
I'll have one whiskey, one porter, one rye, and bring me some cider, I'll give that a try. Bring me two rums, one buttered, one cold, and bring me a scotch at least 7 years old. Then bring on the wine, I'll start with a port, and wash it all down with a beer of some sort. Some brandy, some sherry, some grog, and some ale, some old Mountain Dew, and a...